you take a little bit of issue with the idea of magical realism as sort of this fashionable Latin American style of writing, and you say that in a sense it's just another word for fantasy. So how do you think magical realism has a way of maybe shortchanging the repertorial realities of what it's like to live in a place like Mexico?
I find most of it fanciful and kind of uninteresting and playful in a boring way. The great magical realists, or the great fabulists, you might say, are Borges. I'd say Garcia Marquez, maybe a couple of others. But for anyone to do it now, I mean, people sitting in New York City or in Mexico City and writing magical realism while life is going on around them, you know, it is a bit absurd. And yet, when I say that, I was in places where, I mean, I was in a village, you may remember from the book, it's called Santa Maria Ixtapec, where they have a statue, a carving of the crucifixion of Jesus having fallen, the third fall, and it actually bleeds. The hair grows on the statue, and local people say it bleeds. I suppose writing about that, that's a sort of magical realism. You live in a village where there's these amazing things happen. But I think my objection is when it's done mechanically, according to a program, you know, people saying, I'm a magical realist. Well, there are so many examples of it that strike me as bogus, particularly in a place where there's so much realism, not magical realism, but realism, hyperrealism, surrealism almost of life in Mexico. For example, the cartels, the violence of the cartels is so amazingly cruel and so, you know, blindingly effective. Decapitations, dismembering corpses, hanging them from bridges and so forth. That's not magical realism. That's a sort of hyper-realism that you only have to describe, and you seem to be describing another reality, but you're describing the everyday life of say a border city in most cases. So my problem isn't so much with magical realism. My problem is with programmatic writing. You know, people who write in stream of consciousness, or anyone affecting a style, rather than writing as they are, I suppose. And they're affecting a style that's been used, that's sort of worn out. You don't criticize James Joyce for writing in stream of consciousness, but something that bothers me a lot about writing, and particularly travel writing, is a lot of travel writing is written in the present tense. And I'm walking down the street in San Miguel de Allende. I see a man. He smiles at me. He offers me an avocado. I say to him, Buenos dias, senor. He smiles back. That sort of thing. Hmm. It doesn't grab me. I tell, when I have students, I say, you know, write as plainly as you can. Don't affect a style. Don't draw attention to your style. Style should be transparent. And subject matter should arise out of, I suppose, your experiences. They may be ghostly or magical. But I tend also to think that all writing, all art, is autobiographical. And that that when people are writing about fabulous beasts or whatever it is, I don't know, transformation and so forth, but it's not autobiographical, that they're kind of avoiding writing about themselves.